In today's video, I'll show you how to make a simple code system that if you type a specific word and redeem it, it'll say redeem code and you'll earn money. This can also store multiple different types of codes, as you can see. I have three codes built into the system. I got $300. If you were to type in a wrong code, it will say invalid code. And if you were to type the code, same code again, or then it will say already redeemed. And we can also get a nice notification down here. Okay, without further ado, let's get right into the video. Let's start off by pressing our service and adding in a leaderstats script. You can copy and paste this from the description below and make sure to rename the script leaderstats so you know what it is. Okay, once you've got that done, we can close this and press on our start GUI. Insert screen GUI, we can rename this to codes GUI, and we can go add in a frame and scale this to a nice size. I'll do that. Okay. Let's find it. There we go. Inside of this frame, I'm going to use in a text button. I'm going to set this frame to a nice blue color. And then set this to a nice darker blue color. Okay. Let's rename this to enter our code. So we can do is enter code. And we can go text scaled. And as the font, I'm going to be using source and semi-bold. And make it actually fill the area like that. I think that looks better. Okay, enter our code. And actually, this frame's a bit big. I'm going to make it a bit smaller. There we go. Now it looks a bit small. Ah, I can't get the right size. Hate it when this happens. Okay. Now, inside of our frame, what we're going to do is we're going to add a text box. What this text box allows you to do is lets you pretty much type in it, which is nice for our code system. Okay, I'm just going to get the exact same color that I used here and paste it into here. Whoops. We have to do that. There we go. Okay, we now have that done. Let's set our font to source and semi-bold. And we're going to set our placeholder text. Don't set the text. This is different. This is the actual text that will be inside of it, whilst the placeholder text will be different. Pretty much, we can do enter code. Whoops. So as you can see, the placeholder text is you can't edit this, and I spelled enter wrong. There we go. And now I still spelled it wrong. Wonderful. Okay. We can enter our code, and let's set this to a lighter color than the rest. Okay, let's go rich text and text scaled. And there we go. Now if we can actually type in here and interact with this. And there we go, you can type it pretty much as long as you want. Wonderful. Okay. Whew, once we have this done, we have to, we have to store a code. So we have to check if the codes are valid or not. And in order to check that, we can create a new script. We can actually copy our leader stats. We can go copy that and paste that into here. But rename this to codes. So pretty much we're gonna check if our code is valid. So let's do 0 because 0 is true and 1 is false. Or no. No, 0 is false and 1 is true, I think. Well, that's what we're gonna be doing. Okay, I'm gonna use two codes. I'm gonna do code 1 and just duplicate this, paste that in. And we can rename this to code 2. Wonderful. What we want to do is we actually want to make this equal to codes down here. There we go. Make sure this is equal to this folder right here. Okay. We can now close out of that. That's done. Now let's click on replicate storage and create a new folder. This is going to be our codes folder where we're going to actually store in our remote events. What these remote events will do is they'll take a signal from here and then implant it here. Before I do that, I'm going to rename this to code storage. There we go, code code storage. Let's rename this remote event to code 1 and duplicate that and rename this one to code 2. And then duplicate this once more and rename this to return. Okay, so the reason why we need a return is because this is going to return the code to give us our. So if the code has already been entered, we can do already entered, like you've seen. Okay. Anyways, inside of our text button, what we have to do is insert a local script. We can go local rs is going to be equal to game colon get service, and then we're going to be getting our replicate storage, and then local codes are equal to rs colon wait for child codes, and then local code one is going to be equal to codes dot code one, and then we can duplicate this and paste down here and rename that to code two and paste it one more time and rename this one to return. Okay, make sure that these things have to be called code one. Don't change it to like your actual code or else that will screw up everything. Make sure that they're called code one. Also, let's rename these variables to the actual one, return. Okay, let's add one more variable and call this one local box is going to be equal to script.parent.text box. Okay, now we can do is we can go script.parent.mouse button one click colon connect and then function, and then we can function our player. Okay, that's a lot of variables. Let's check if this is where we're actually going to implant what our codes are. So we can do is if box.text is going to be equal to, well actually equal to, so if it's equal to, let's do our first code, which is going to be like, and then we can simply press enter. Hold, I'll create a little note and call on like is your code. Okay, if you want, you guys can put this there, so if you ever get lost and want to change that code up, you can do this. Nah, I don't know why I was thinking of something else to say, but I couldn't come up with anything else to say. It's just this is what will be written in here, so when somebody types in here, yeah, that's pretty much, yeah. Nothing too special. Okay, anyways. Okay, so what we can now do is, then what we can do is we have to go code one colon fire server player, and then we can just do else if box dot else if, then we can just copy this, and then we have to do else if box.text is equal to, let's do something like code, then, okay, let's make sure code is your code. Okay, just giving a reminder. Okay, what we can do is, now what we have to do is we have to go code2 colon fire server and player. Now, if none of this is true, what we can actually do is we can set the text. What we can do is box.text is going to be equal to this, and then box.placeholder text is going to be equal to invalid code. And then what we can do is we can wait 3 seconds, and then in 3 seconds what we can do is box.placeholder text is going to be equal to enter code. Wonderful. Okay, one more. So now we can do is we have to check, what we're going to do is we're going to check if this has been fired. So what we can do is return colon on no, dot on client event colon connect and then function, then we don't have to function our player. If we do, then I'll just type that in. But anyways, what we can do is copy this, but instead we can rename this. Instead of invalid code, we can do already redeemed. Redeemed. So the code has already been redeemed. Okay, if we were to press play, you should see that under our player, we have our codes folder. And actually, we don't have our codes. Why is that? Let's see why we don't have our codes. Hold on. Oh, I know why we don't have our codes. What we actually have to do is we have to go and parent this to leader stats. Because that's what we called our local here. Okay, that's a bit confusing. Okay, so this is pretty much just a variable. This can be whatever you want. Just ignore that it's called local and this is called storage, and just ignore that this is called storage if you copied it. I sort of did a mess up there, but it's fine, it will work. Okay, so now if we press play, under our players and under this, we should see that we have code 1 and code 2, and the value is 0. If we were to type in like and enter the code, nothing will happen. But if we were to type in like with a lowercase l, it will say invalid code, and then 3 seconds it'll go back to enter code. Okay, so we know this works because we didn't enter a valid code. Now what we can do is we actually have to add in what is it called? Let's add a new one and let's go rename this script to code manager. There we go, this is gonna be our code manager. And then inside of our code manager, what we can do is we can actually copy these the first five variables and paste them into here. Okay. What we can do is code 1 dot on server event colon connect function and then player. And then we can do is we can check if player dot codes dot code one. So pretty much in our code storage, we are doing is we are getting this and then we're checking if it's actually equal, if the value of code one is equal to 0, because we want to make sure that it's equal to 0. Okay, so if it's equal to 0, then what will happen is it will run this next code. Okay, so we can do is we can go, if it's equal to 0, then let's go copy this, paste this down in here, and we can do is equal to 1, so that this won't happen again. And then we can do player.leaderstats.money.value is equal to, actually plus equals 100. This is how much you want you to add. I'm going to do 100. And actually what we forgot to define value in here, which good thing I did or else we'd have some issues. Also, that's why you have your output if you're watching. Okay. Okay, what we can now do is else. So if this is equal to false, we can do is we can just return. So else return dot on server event colon connect function and then player. Okay, there we go. So now this will function our player. And now right here we can go control C and whoops, what happened? I'm going to go control Y. Okay, let's go copy this and let's just go a few. There we go. Actually, why did this happen? That is very confusing. That should not have happened. Wait, I think I may have done an error here. No. I don't know what happened. Oh, we're functioning the player. Whoops. Okay, I know what happened. Okay, dot on dot, we're supposed to go colon fire client and then our player. Okay, that's where we got it wrong. Okay, We weren't supposed to, I screwed up. Okay, there we go. We can now paste this in here and set code to, and then my else we can go return in fire player. And yeah, this should be just about it. So, if we hit play, and we type in our right code, so like, enter our code, we will get, how do we get 200? Let's see, why did I get 200 there? That was a bit interesting. Like, oh, I think I know what happened. We have to type in code 2 here. Okay, now that should be it, and this should work perfectly fine. So what we were to do is we were type in like. Oh, that was invalid because I typed in an uppercase. But like, we get 100. And then if we were to type in like once more, it'll say already redeemed, which is nice. Okay, and what we can do is we can also do, if we type in code, invalid code. If we type in our actual code, then we can redeem it. And if we try redeeming it again, there you go. But before we end this tutorial, let's quickly create a close system. Let's go here, frame, insert a text button. Actually, we can go into our, if we want to actually insert this into our actual codes, whoops. Let's insert this in our actual codes GUI. Place this down here, and let's just do, this is probably the hardest part of the tutorial. Okay. Let's go into semi-bold, text scaled, and rename this to codes. And I'm going to set this to blue. Okay, there we go. And now we can do is we can set this frame to be visible. And inside of here, we can just do is add in a script. Where's it? Why can I not insert a script? That is interesting. Okay, that was a bit weird. It just didn't give me the option to insert a script there. But anyway, script.parent. Mouse button click, colon connect, and then function. And then just we're going to function. Inside here, what we can do is we can go script.parent.parent. frame.visible is equal to not this will pretty much change the visibility to what it's not at right currently. So, and just like that, we're done. We can press this and open and close it. So before we end, if you want to save this, because right now inside of our code storage and our code leader stats, you can actually add this to a data store. If you're to add this to a data store, then it will actually save. But just like leader stats, this won't save unless you add to a data store. There's lots of tutorials out there, and if you want me to make a data store tutorial, tell me in the comment section below. Okay, thanks for watching.